Hey, what's up, Factory family and friends? I have a quick, important announcement, and that is this. We are working on being back in the building. And I'm excited about that. Our potential opening date for being back will be July 4th. That will be our first real Sunday morning service. Now, we're gonna have some practice services leading up to that. The first two services will be Thursday night, 7:30 p.m. Those dates will be June 10th and June 17th. And we're gonna have these practice services because we've got new equipment for our live streaming. And with these practice services will help us to use this equipment as well as help us to see how we're going to be doing the services. So that will be June 10th, June 17th. Now these practice services will be for leadership only. Leadership only. Then on June 27th, we're gonna have three services. These three services will be for all of our volunteers. That will be on a Sunday, June 27th. Again, three services for all volunteers. And then finally, July 4th, we will have three services open for everyone. We would love to see you at those three services. Now again, we will be back in the building. Notice I didn't say we will be reopening. And the reason I didn't say that we will be reopening, as far as I'm concerned, we have never closed. We simply haven't been in the building. Literally, we've still been having discipleship groups. As I speak now, we're drilling a well in Kenya, as I speak. We also have gotten another well surveyed or the land surveyed, and we're simply awaiting the permit for a second well in Kenya. So we haven't been in the building, but we have been being the church. We've still been feeding the homeless on a regular basis. So we will simply be back in the building. We are not reopening. Now, why were we out of the building in the first place? My answer is simple. I just thought it was the best way to protect sheep. And everybody didn't agree with that, and I can live with that. We were out of the building because I wanted to protect sheep. I didn't know all of the ins and outs of COVID-19, and I still don't know. Why are we coming back into the building? I think that we can be in the building now, and I believe that we can better mitigate some of the potential risk for danger. I know that I have been vaccinated, many of you have. I'm not saying that you have to get vaccinated, but for those who are awaiting a vaccine, you will have time to have done that by July 4th. For those of you who don't believe in the vaccine, you can come and you can still feel like, hey, you don't have anything to worry about. I leave that up to you. That's not for me to make those decisions. Like most everything else, unfortunately, COVID-19, this whole pandemic, for most people, it's been handled politically. Like almost everything else, I think that's unfortunate that it's been handled politically. For me, I am seeking to handle it pastorally. That's what I've sought to do over this past, 14 months. I want to handle everything that I do, even before the pandemic, pastorally. So guess what? I'm not smart enough to pontificate on COVID-19. I'm not smart enough to assess the media. Are they stoking fear, like some people have said? That's above my pay grade. I'm not smart enough to talk about the pros and cons of masks and vaccines and Dr. Fauci and social distancing. I am not wise enough, smart enough, to wax eloquently on those issues. Here's what I'm called to do. I'm called to feed sheep. I'm called to lead sheep. I'm called to look out for sheep and to seek to protect sheep. I do that. I put my face on the ground or I lift my face to the sky and I seek to hear from God. So let me say this as I close, and I want to say this humbly. I am not looking for an argument. So if you want to comment something where you express your disagreement with me in the comments, you're not going to get an argument from me. And I'd rather you even call me or talk to me personally. I am not looking for an argument. But let me also say this. I'm not looking for your approval either. I'm not looking for your affirmation. I'm not looking to take a vote. Pastoring can be a lonely place, but I love what my father told me the other day as he talked about losing my mom. He said, I'm alone, but I'm not alone. I know that I haven't been alone over this past 14 months, so I'm not looking to argue with you, but I don't need your approval either. I'm gonna love you whether you agree or disagree with me. And then finally, I wanna say thanks. The support that we have gotten as a church has been unreal. It's actually been overwhelming and even brought me to tears from time to time. We don't do what we do for money, but it has been a blessing to know that our giving has been steady, consistent. I know several churches that don't have that testimony. So I simply want to thank you. Y'all have been faithful. I want to say this too. Look for more details regarding logistics and protocols for our upcoming service. This has been a tough season. The last 12 to 14 months has been tough. And so I know that I've been praying, and that's what we want to continue to do. Your prayers are appreciated, and they are also solicited. Again, we're looking forward to being back in the building July 4th, and we will have some services beforehand. We love you. We can't wait to see you. God bless you. Peace out.